Hi guys, it's Rachel, and I'm going to be doing a little bit of gameplay for The Sims 3 Supernatural. It came out on Friday in the UK, but I got it yesterday because Amazon, I don't know, but I did pre-order it, but instead of it coming on Friday like it should have, it came yesterday, which was Saturday. Anyway. This is my sim. Her name is Merla DiCapolo, and she's a witch, and right now she is in her underground basement area, which I have built for her. She has one elixir which she's made. It's called the Vial of Bliss, and it says Sims who drink this won't be bored or lonely anytime soon. Which means that it basically increases their fun and social needs, and it leaves them static for a little while. So yeah, we have this, and I've also got down here an alchemy station and a couple of little shelves for potions and such. And we've also got Bonehilda, who is our skeleton maid. Those of you who played The Sims Making Magic, that was way back in Sims 1, it was the final expansion pack, will remember this NPC. Well, she has made a return in Supernatural, which is awesome. If we go up here, we might just spot her. I don't actually know if she's around right now. And I've got some pea shooters out back. If you pre-ordered, then you get the limited edition Plants and Zombies content, which included this pea shooter, which is handy because I do have some plants over here. I'm growing a few ingredients. And we've got a zombie here who is eating my plants, so I'm going to tell the zombie, have the pea shooter attack this zombie. Her name is Ashley Edscar. And here we're just growing some plants. We've got some mandrake, some red valerian, wolfsbane, and these are all things that can be used to make elixirs. So yeah, hopefully the pea shooter will start attacking her soon. Pea shooters aren't always the best though. They don't always like work the way they should. But hopefully once we can also learn an elixir, which means that we can de-zombify people. I think we can anyway. But anyway, I'm gonna have Merla come up here and take a bath. You'll also notice I've got some new furniture up here. There's this new fridge, if you can really see that. We've got some decorative books over here. And this really there's a really cool lamp over here, which actually alters your Sim's mood. So if we set the colour to yellow and turn on the lamp, then okay, that's not really very yellow. We'll try another colour. Okay, I'm gonna try purple. Okay, you can see it, how it kind of turns everything else in the room kind of purple. And if we bring Merla out here, then she will actually turn purple and she will get a moodlet. So I'm just gonna bring her out here after she's done with her bath. okay, she's like bathing with all her clothes on. I don't know why. I'm guessing that's a glitch. I don't really know why she's doing that. That's kind of funny. But it increased her hygiene anyway. So she gets this moodlet, which is Feelings Purple. It says, somewhere between joy and sadness, above healthy but around just around the corner from queasy, there is a place where one just feels kind of purple. Nerla feels purple. So there we go. Now, Merla has got a slight purple tint to her skin, which is very cool, and it matches her hair accessory. And oh my goodness, so there's another zombie. There's two zombies actually. Ooh. These pea shooters are not doing a very good job. I have to admit, they're not. But they're still a pretty cool item to have. Oh my god, that zombie's like vomiting all over my lot. Okay, we should buy some more of these. There we go. The pea shooter's now attacking that other zombie. Because I don't want the zombies eating my plants. Okay. So the pea shooter has just attacked this zombie. Although it doesn't actually kill them, it just kind of puts them to sleep for a while. Which is annoying. Well, they can't really be killed, they're already dead. Okay. Okay, Marilla's going to sleep now. And it is a full moon, so I'm gonna have her, don't know, where can we go? We'll go to the Broom Arena, if I can find it. Yep, here we are, just so I can show off this feature. Now you're about to see Merla riding on her broom. There it is. Now let's follow her. I like how there's little sparkles coming from the broom. I don't know, I just think that's a nice little touch. So let's just fast forward. Okay, we're here. So this is the Broom Arena. It kind of reminds me of Quidditch in Harry Potter. So anyway, we're going to tell Merla to do a stunt ride. I don't know, I think it's cool. And it's slowly coming into the daytime now, so hopefully you should see it better. Okay, she's on her broom. Okay. And she's just flying around up there. I'm gonna try and zoom in so you guys can like see her properly. I can't actually keep up with her. She's going too fast, but she's almost like surfing on the broom, which is really cool. I don't know if there's a like a broom skill or something, because I would like to see if there's some more options available. But I don't. Maybe it depends on the kind of broom you have. I'm not really sure. Another really cool thing about witches is that they have the ability to transform any. I'll show you this. Right, we're gonna conjure an apple, and then we can basically turn that apple into any collectible. Okay, we're gonna cast spell, and this is learned, and it's unlocked at level 1 of alchemy. Okay, get off the broom, please. So basically what it does is it will turn any collectible into another, like a rock, a bug, anything, which you can then sell on for money. So it's a great way of making money in your game if you're like me and you don't use cheats. Although I did use cheats for this sim because I created her purely for the purposes of this gameplay video. Okay, so hopefully this will be successful. There we go, we've got our apple here. So we'll see in a minute what she transformed it to, if it is successful. And she has transformed it into mandrake seeds that are really bad quality. So we'll try it again and see if we can get something a bit better. Although we need to be careful because witches also have this magic meter, and basically this tells you how much magic your sim still has available. Fairies have this as well, but I will get into that in another video. Okay, so let's see. And it's okay. Basically, you could just keep doing this forever. I'm gonna try one more time and see if I can get something valuable. Okay, we got a dragonfish, which is pretty cool. I'm gonna zoom in, let you guys see. That is a pretty cool looking fish, and it breathes fire. So that is awesome. I've never seen that before. So we're just gonna put. Okay. Oh, it's not gonna let us collect it, but you can basically just keep converting and converting. Okay. And Merla's decided that she wants to go on the the broom thing again. Anyway. We're going to get her to come down with from there and see if there are any sims in the neighbourhood. Okay. We've got a playground over here. Didn't even notice, but we're going to go to Edie Park because it seems to be the most central location. Much like Central Park in Sunset Valley, which is the main neighbourhood that I play. Okay, so here we are. There's a few people here. We have a fairy. This is who's this? Dahlia Goodfellow and her child, Fawn Goodfellow. You can see her wings there, they're blue. And the thing about fairies is you get to choose the shape of their wings and the colour of them, which is awesome. So anyway, we're going to have Merla go and greet this fairy lady. Hello, it's very nice to meet you. And we're going to cast a charm The only one we know at the moment is the good luck charm, and I'm not really sure what it does, so I guess we'll find out in a minute. I think it just gives her some luck. Now, oh, what's this moodlet? It is the Wow, a fairy. And she just gets that for socializing with a fairy, which was pretty cool. So let's see if this works. She looks terrified. Oh wow, there was like rainbows and everything coming out. Okay, I think that worked. I don't know. Okay. Oh yeah, and there's also new traits. There is proper, night owl, supernatural fan, supernatural skeptic, and brooding and gatherer. Okay, who's this? Chester Swain. Okay. And this is Dee Dee Wynn. And is there anyone else here? It doesn't look like it. But anyway, I'm gonna have Marilla now go home, and I'm gonna show off the alchemy. Okay, so into the basement. Okay, we're going to mix elixir. Okay, we only know one at the moment, and she needs to pee as well. So she can do that. And you guys, you might have just caught a wee glimpse of Bonehilda there. And here she is, and I think she looks really cool actually. Like with the bones and everything and the way she moves. But yeah, this is Bonehilda. And she is basically just a maid. But she's not playable, unfortunately. Well, I don't know if she is. I don't know if you can actually like build a relationship with her, but yeah. Anyway, what is Mella doing? She's eating brain freeze a la mode. Okay. This is, I experimented with this before. When I was just playing about with the game yesterday with a werewolf who had a trick played on him by a fairy called Hothead, which made steam come out of him. No, she made his teeth, made him cold by using a trick called Chattering Teeth, and he then ate this. Well, he ate this because he was warm. I don't know. But anyway, I'm gonna have Merla come downstairs, and she can work on her alchemy. No, she's decided that she wants to go to bed. Well, that's just not what we wanted. And she's a night owl as well, which means she sleeps for longer. I never give her much sleep because I'm always wanting to play with the new features. But anyway, so research alchemy, please. And she's a witch, so she gains a skill faster. She's already at level 1. Oh, she's at level 2, sorry. Okay. And she's learned a recipe for a jar of friendship, which I think just means that Sims will become, she can cast a spell on Sims and they can like become friends. Okay. And I'm gonna have her go and tend the garden now. because that's where she can grow ingredients. And I think she can also buy them from the consignment store. I never showed off Mirla's outfit. She's wearing this top, this blue top, kind of gypsy style top, and this long skirt to frill detail. It's actually two separate pieces. It looks as though it's one. And then she has her hairstyle, which I actually really like. And it's got a nice accessory in her hair, which is also good. Everything that her outfit and her hairstyle both came with Supernatural. So yeah, she's tending the garden. Hopefully the zombies haven't destroyed it too much. Okay. And she can also dispose of the dead plants. And it's a full moon again tonight. That's because I have my game set on like full moon all the time, which you can easily change through the options, which is it's cut under environment options, and you can set to a rotating lunar cycle. Which means so you can set like the number of days that are in a lunar cycle, and you can set to single lunar phase, which are different phases of the moon. So there's full moon, waxing crescent, first quarter. What I don't know what these mean, but yeah. But I've got it set to full moon at the moment, which is probably not good because, well, it makes zombies appear. A zombie called Kyle Hong. If you've been here before, let's have that pea shooter attack. Okay. She needs to get her mail. I don't know what the mail is. Smelted mail. Oh, yes. That's right. Earlier, when I was playing earlier, I turned an apple into a like piece of something and I got it smelted, which sounds so funny because it sounds like it smells. Okay, so we're gonna go to here, which I think is the consignment store, and we're gonna see if we can buy some elixirs. Or anything. What can we buy here? The person at the cash desk is called Oakley Bean. I don't know why that makes me laugh, it just does. Okay, so buy. Please. We'd like to buy. Okay. Pile of blue topaz. Skill booster, flask of sleep. So I guess that puts us into sleep. There are recipes, bottled vampire's bite, turns us into a clone drone. Potent cure. Beeswax, liquid job booster. So I'm gonna try the skill booster and we're gonna drink that and we'll see what happens. Well, I know it's gonna boost one of our skills, but which skill will it boost? if it works. Okay. I don't know, did she improve a skill? I think it just like helps to boost skill levels. Not skill levels, but the amount of time spent at a certain skill level, if you know what I mean. And there's a rocking chair here, and it actually rocks, which is really cool. And there's a fairy here. And she's got really awesome wings, and they look like blood, which is really cool. Can you hear the Pixies, the Simlish version of Pixie Lott's Mama Do on the gramophone over here, which is another new object that came with the game. Anyway. So, yeah. Merla's gonna go home now. Yeah, there seems to be a lot of babies in that place. But there's different hangouts for all supernaturals. I think there's a ghost bar, there's a vampire bar, I'm sure there's a werewolf place, but I've yet to discover it. Okay. So since Merla needs to go to sleep now, I'm going to end this gameplay video here, but I hope you enjoyed it, because I really enjoyed showing you guys some gameplay with witches, and or with a witch, and yeah, I will talk to you all very soon in my next video, which will hopefully be with the Salisbury family, or I'll do another gameplay video, or possibly another supernatural gameplay video, or possibly my review, which is coming up soon. Until then, bye!